Errol Barnett is at the White House with the latest. Errol, good morning.
Good morning. Weeks after declaring a national emergency at the southern border, President Trump has ratcheted up his immigration rhetoric. Eager to show the press the first completed sections of the southern border wall, President Trump has increased his attacks on migrants from Central America. And the president is threatening Mexico with dire economic consequences if it doesn't do more to help.
Well, we're going to shut it down if we have to, but Mexico can do it very easily.
Surrounded by Republican lawmakers and Border Patrol agents, President Trump retreated from his threat to shut down the entire southern border.
We're going to shut it down if we have to. We're going to tariff the cars coming in that they make in Mexico if we have to.
Border Patrol officers said the newly renovated wall has already helped them.
In these 2 miles, just illegal entries alone have dropped by 75%.
At a roundtable on border security, the president went as far as declaring asylum seekers a hoax.
The system is full. Can't take you anymore. Asylum, you know, I look at some of these asylum people. They're gang members. They're not afraid of anything. They have lawyers greeting them. They read what the lawyer tells them to read. They're gang members. And they say, I fear for my life. And all of a sudden, Mexico's doing terrifically.
While the president denied he changed his mind about shutting down the border Friday, this was his vow just last week.
And I'm telling you right now, we will close the damn border. We'll keep it closed for a long time. I'm not playing games.
The reversal comes after warnings from leaders within the GOP.
Closing down the border would have potentially catastrophic economic impact on our country.
In California, the president also laid out plans to complete his wall once and for all.
And we expect to have close to 400 miles done within about 2 years from now. That's a lot. 400 miles will cover most of it.
Now, California is leading a group of more than 20 states asking a federal judge to stop President Trump from diverting federal funds to build this southern border wall. They call this unconstitutional, and they say to construct a wall under these circumstances would cause them irreparable damage. Michelle?
All right, Errol, thank you.